Hey, good morning people, welcome to couldnt talks. So today I'm going to do a video on the first ride, and we are heading straight to Shivanasamudra from there to celebrate our first year anniversary for our motor club, Ride and Drive motor club. We are heading towards a resort named Sky Blue Orchid Resort, which is near Kanakpura Road. So let's start the day. Jai Shri Ram. Okay, so we have reached the meter point. So it's only four riders: Santosh, Ajay, and Mr. Raghu. So first we are heading straight to Shivanasamudra. Before that, we're going to have a breakfast in Madavalli. From there, go to Shivanasamudra. From Shivanasamudra to the resort. Stay tuned in. So talking about the bike, I took the bike on 27th of last month. I've ridden about like close to 528 kilometers for now, and the experience has been wonderful. So you see here, this one, switch it on, and now I'm in 105. I don't want to just go in 105, I'd rather just go a little and press it down. See, stuck to 97, and I keep just moving. I've taken my hands out. I can still balance the bike using, what do you say, my seat, but however, I don't recommend you guys doing that. So until unless you just press the brake pedal, the cruise control will be still on, and this is very smooth. And since it has a, what do you say, steering damper, you will not find, what do you say, the shake or okay, when you run on a hump or a bump, right, the bike will still be stable. So that's one of the good feature. So now you would have noticed it is not, what is say, an adaptive cruise control, it's just a normal cruise control. So it's just going smooth as is. I'm trying to just control the bike using, what is say, using my legs, so I can just go a little like this and a little like that, all right, but not too much. But I would not recommend you guys to just leave your handle. I'd rather say, like, you know, hold your handle. And to speak about other stuff, I have mode, right? So on the go, I can still change the modes, right? I like to see, dynamic is nothing but the sports mode kind of a thing, which has about like 90% of the power, right? So if you look at it, so it says dynamic. I can change it to enduro. Enduro, when you switch on enduro, it is like, you know, the ABS, the rear wheel, right, gets cut off. So this is mostly used when you actually go off-road. Since it's actually like in a new bike, I haven't given for service, so service will be done by next week most probably, right? I hope by then I'll just finish the 1,000 kilometer mark. But any which ways, next week is gonna be 1 month, so I'm gonna just leave the bike for servicing. So during that point of time, maybe they'll just unlock the enduro pro mode and the dynamic pro mode. So dynamic pro and the enduro pro is kind of like an adjustment where we can actually like decide what kind of a power the bike should be using. And enduro pro is used purely for off-roading, and dynamic pro is nothing but like in a where we just set the speed to the highest, so where we use the engine capacity to the fullest, right? And as you see here, I have the windscreen. Okay, the windscreen can be like adjusted, and people usually go for the higher windscreen, but I would not say that, because the windscreen design is such a way that here, if you see, there's a small what do you say, bend where the air just hits here and goes above your helmet. So I could feel the air near the helmet, not on my face, So that's something like, you know, which BMW has come up with, a brilliant design. And to speak about the weight of the bike is about like 258 kgs. So yes, it is a hefty bike. But as far as I see, like, you know, when you're riding the bike, I don't see any challenge, because the weight is more of in the center that makes you to, what do you say, handle the bike more efficiently. And cornering is going to be so easy, and I didn't find any kind of a challenge while cornering, right? And this bike is an absolute beauty with a 25 liter tank, right? You see, it's a massive tank, right? So you'd be a, what do you say, a kind of an attraction on the road. People will just definitely say, see the bike, and you, not you obviously, it's the bike, right, which actually, like, you know, attracts people. Overall, I'm in love with the bike. So I was more of a road guy, and I also started thinking that, you know, why not I just take the bike off-road. So I haven't tried off-roading yet. Off-roading will definitely happen, right? Well, maybe I'll just do a different video for that. But on-road, it is butter smooth. If I have to just talk about the bike and the console and everything, it will take the entire day, right? Because, you know, one video is not enough to explain the feature of the bike. This bike is loaded with feature. The price which I paid for is like, you know, 17,75,850 or something. That should be the precise price, all right? And got it from JSP Motorrad, Bangalore, Koramangala, all right? And they're pretty helpful. It's a very new company, or rather say, like, you know, very new dealership, and their services are very good. CC, 850.
Huh?
850.
350.
850. 850. 850. Right on time. So the gate will open at 9 a.m. So we were sharp at 9, so luckily we were the first one to just enter. It looks very beautiful. ನೀರಿಲ್ಲ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಯಾರು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾ ಅದು ಹೋಗೋಣ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನೋ ಫ್ಲೈ ಝೋನು ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ವಿಡ್ ರೀಚ್ಡ್ ಶಿವನಸಮುದ್ರ ಅಟ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 9 AM ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಪೆಂಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಚಾಟಿಂಗ್ Nothing much to do because, you know, there was no water. But still, the ride was amazing. Now we are heading straight to Sky Blue Orchid Resort in Kanakpura Road. Thank you. Alrighty, so we have done with our anniversary ride, and bye bye Sky Blue Orchids. We're gonna start back to home. So Raghu wanted to just do a test ride. ಹೇಗಿತ್ತು
ಮೂರು ತಿಂಗಳು ನನ್ನ ಕಮಿಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಈಗ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ ಅದನ್ನು ಸೈಡ್ಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇದನ್ನ ನಾಳೆ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ ಬೆಣ್ಣೆ ಸರ್
ಅಲ್ಲ
ಬೆಣ್ಣೆ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಇದನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡು ಇನ್ನು ನನ್ನ ಲೈಫಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಯಾವ ಯಾವುದು
ಗಾಡಿ ಬೇಡ ಆರಾಮ್ ಸಾಕು
ಸಾಕಿದ್ರು